Hello everyone. Today we're going to test pump a water well. Our main goal here is to find out how much the well makes so we can size a pump to put into it. The pump that was in the well wasn't working anymore, so we pulled it out and dropped in a half horse pump that'll make about 15 gallons a minute. On this well they use cement rings for a powder casing, and then they set the plastic liner in the middle for a sand screen, put a fitless adapter on it going out through the side. There's also a collection pipe that comes in from the side at about 6 foot below ground level. It runs sideways for about 130 feet, and they're using the water that comes out of that to dump into the cement rings. And then they pump it down the pipeline and out to the stock tanks that are watering the livestock. This well is going to be used for watering livestock on pasture ground. It's got 5 different stock tanks on it that it's the primary well for. We also have backup wells that are able to feed into the system too, so we still want this one to be able to do whatever it can pump. It's also a backup well for about a dozen other stock tanks. So the more water we can get, the better off we are. The collection pipe comes out of the well, underneath the back of the truck, and then out across this low spot. They've got a marker pipe on the other end of it for a vent. It's hard to tell on the video, but the ground level stays pretty flat out to about here, and then it drops off a couple of feet. We're guessing the water level out here in this low to be maybe 4 foot to water. And that could change throughout the year depending on how much rain they've had. In Colorado, these wells are known as a gallery well or an infiltration well. They're really not all that common. I've only put in a couple of them, and I only know where there's a couple others at. But they do still have construction standards for them, and they're still an option if your water level's shallow enough. It's just not all that often around here that you've got a 4 foot water level to start working with. One thing you'll notice on this well is it doesn't look all that clean. There's cobwebs hanging around on it and a little bit of stuff on top of the water. The top lid on this had a crack in it that was missing a chunk, so it just barely covered the hole. It kept the mice out. Definitely let the spiders and bugs in. Looks a lot more like a basement than it does a well. We put a steel lid on it that fits good and also sealed up where the wires are coming through the side. It needed just a little bit of caulking there. Other than that, it looked to be in pretty good shape. Here you can start to make out the pipe that's coming in the side. It's still under the water, but it's close enough that you can see it through the water now. We've been pumping on it about 45 minutes here. The water level had gone down about 2.5 feet. But it was still going down slowly, so we weren't quite to pumping what the well was making yet. We were still drawing it down. I've got a video that goes over the pipeline into this project too. It's kind of long, but it's a big system. We've got about 10 wells and probably someplace around 20 miles of pipeline tied together here. It takes a little while to go over. We're still pumping out more than what the well's producing. I'm guessing there's about 1,000 gallons stored in the gravel around that sideways lateral. It took quite a while for this one to pump down. That's one thing that you have to watch when you're test pumping, is to make sure that the production level has stabilized as well as the production rate. In this case, we're going to suck it down enough that we actually get to where we're getting air, and then we can start to establish how much the well itself can make. Everything else that was in there was just storage. The inside casing is just a little bit deeper than what the sand level on the outside there is. The water's running out of the lateral and going down through the sand into the inside casing. Because this well can change its water level and production throughout the year, we're going to put a sump pump float switch in between the two casings there. And that way it'll automatically adjust to however much the well is making. The well ended up making 5 gallons a minute, but we can put in a pump that makes more than that, and it'll take advantage of the storage and automatically adjust itself turn itself on and off to match what the well's doing.